This video is going to be very personal and transparent and very dear to my heart, but it's also very inspired by a recent favorite ASMR artist of mine, and that is Diary of a Millennial ASMR. Now, I know I have mentioned videos, and I ask you, please, if you are not subscribed to her channel, please go check her out. She's awesome. But she recently did a video with some memorabilia, and she showed her past journals that she wrote in as a child and a teenager, and she also made a video where she read the entries in said journals, and I just thought it was the most awesome idea because it just really shows her and us how far she's come and grown as a person. And so I've decided to do my own type of reading from my journal, but my journals are a little bit different. My journals are prayer journals. Now, I know that I've done a lot of religious content recently, and I told you guys I do not want to throw my religion in your face. I'm not a Bible thumper. I'm just a born-again Christian, I guess you could say. And when I write in my journal, it's usually prayers, but I want to share them with you guys. I just thought it would be a fun idea, but I can't take all the credit. I just want to thank Diary of a Millennial for inspiring me to do this video. But my journals are written in notebooks, except for the journals that Miss Paula sent me in the mail. I do those more personal journal entries, so I'm not going to share those, but I will share my prayer journal entries. These entries I did in December when I did the Purpose Driven Life. I definitely recommend, if you are a Christian, to do the Purpose Driven Life. It's amazing. I did it once when I was in my early 20s, all the way through. And then I did it this time. I think I missed a couple days, but yeah, I almost finished the whole thing again. And it's just, if you're trying to grow in your religion, it's definitely one of the best ways to do so. I definitely recommend Purpose Driven Life. It's amazing and thought provoking, and it's just wonderful, so I definitely recommend it. But I'm going to share with you guys some of the entries from my prayer journal. I've tried to do this video so many times, guys. I don't know what happened the last time, but it wasn't picking up the audio, so that's why I'm wearing an earphone this time, because I want to make sure that it picks up the audio this time. I want to skip the first few because I talk about my ex a lot in the first few entries. So let's just start with day 10. Okay, let me lean back. Sorry, my back has hurt me. I went to the theater today with my best friend and her two children to see Inside Out 2 for the second time. That was their first time. That was my second time. And I loved it more the second time than the first time because I got to share it with them. And we had a really good time, but my back is hurting me. I feel like I'm an old lady sometimes with my back, but I told you guys I have scoliosis of the spine. these, what you call it, life pillows that I'm leaning on right now that seems to really help. So, okay, day 10. So this was December 17th, 2023. So how many months ago was that? January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November. Really? Almost a year. Let's just say that. I was like 12 months, ain't no way. But let's just say it's been almost a year. So, day 10. Point to ponder. The heart of worship is surrender. I say, dear God, I have had trust issues all my life. I love the feeling of being in control of my life and my destiny. I want to know who to love or who to trust. I want to know what life has in store for me. Life is a gigantic question mark right now. I let people hurt me that I thought loved me, but yet it should be such a blessing, which is having my true family and friends back. I just hate the feeling of being out of control, but I know only you know what my destiny is, and it won't be lived by what life I want for myself. It will be the life you planned out for me, and it will benefit you and your kingdom. I'm sorry, I just know I have so much love to give, but that's my problem. That's always been my problem, wanting to have that feeling of being out of my mind and love. But this last month, it is your love I crave and have missed for so long. Sometimes the human, confused part of me can rear its ugly head, but me. Dear God, I've tried so hard over the last 12 days to become more like you. I know I'll never be fully like you, but I can definitely feel a change in myself. I wake up more eager, wanting to spend time with you. I consider the country to be the perfect place to grow closer to God, and I've felt in that way. Just the beauty around me is extraordinary. I'm just excited to live life again and to live it for you and through you is my first priority. I no longer want to be selfish and have things my way. My soul has been broken so much. The only being I fully trust is you. I know I can ask why, God, all I want, but what will that do? It'll just be another road bump in life. I'm ready, Lord, use your love and make me more like you. That's all I want. I don't want to waste any more of my life than I already have. I see people around me that are just wasting their lives away. I just don't want to be conformed to that. I want my life to be extraordinary, where even the sun that heats my skin makes me happy, and it does make me happy. Every little thing I open my eyes to makes me happy, like sitting in front of this upstairs window. Sometimes I just want to get away from the world, even if I'm listening to music while writing. Music makes me feel passionate. It makes me want to write more. Today's lesson is partly about honesty. I've been honest for a very long time, keeping my eyes closed to what I knew wasn't right. I don't know why I stayed for so long. I can't really say that I had faith in him, because what did that do to me in the process? Just made me into a person that I refuse to be anymore. I've never really had true faith in anyone but you. Even when I didn't feel it at times, I knew you were never far. You were always there. So I'm ready to live this life where my trust is not on anyone but you. In Jesus' name, amen. Day 13, December 21st, 2023. Point to ponder, God wants all of me. Dear God, I've realized that the days I don't have my time with you has always seemed like a bad day. Yesterday, it felt like the whole world was closing in on me. And then I realized as I laid down to sleep, I didn't have my time with you. And it truly makes a difference in the way I feel and the way I act. I know doing this every day may seem small, but it means everything to me. I feel like I'm beginning to wake up again. Every little thing I notice is beautiful again. Life is beautiful again. But my time with you is a huge part of my new life. Because if it wasn't for you, I don't know who or where I'd be. Where would I be now if I hadn't stepped out in faith and trusted you? Stuck inside my own head is where I'd be. I never want to be back there, where my body is alive, but my spirit is dead, because that is the way it felt. My spirit is supposed to be immortal, but yet living the life I was made me feel so very empty. Maybe I still am a glass half full right now, but at least I'm not empty any longer. I want to have a true loving relationship with you. I want you to be the focus on all my hopes and dreams. I realize that someone other than you in first place. My life was a mess. I don't want anyone to take my eyes off of you again. Truly, I love you. Thank you for not giving up on me. In Jesus' name, amen. December 22nd, 2023, my favorite number in the month after I left my ex. Point to ponder, God is real no matter how I feel. Dear God, I don't know why, but whenever I'm outside, I feel you more. I feel the sun that warms my skin, and I think of you. I hear my brother's chimes, and I think of you. All I know is that a month ago, I was a shell of a person. I didn't even feel emotions anymore. I just got by day, living in sin. My saving grace was my job. God, I'm so grateful. I do what I do for a living. Because if all else fails, and I look at my life in a negative way, I can still say I tried to be a good person. And I tried to be the person God wants me to be. I was never perfect. If I got another CNA job, would I look at it in a different light, knowing what I know now? Probably. I know it would help, and I could try to be a different CNA from the lazy, impatient, selfish CNA I was before. I know you have always been there for me. I know you've never left my side, even on the days that, like Job, I would ask you why. I had a lot of those days and was even told not to believe in you. He made me question my faith, even when he professed to be a Christian. His bad days became my bad days. It is questioning a lack of faith became mine as well. But yet did I always wonder whether this was the life I deserved? No, it wasn't, and that's why I'm where I am now, trying to rebuild a broken relationship. I'm serious about this because if I don't have you, I don't have anything. Just know that I'm trying to be a less human and just listen to my spirit more. Just know I hold so much love in my heart for you. Thank you for saving me. I'm your diamond in the rough. I'm yours always. In Jesus' name, amen. Day 15. Point to ponder. I was born into God's family. Oh God, I hope I did the right thing. Something has been pressing on my heart for the last month. I can't be the bad person. I believe in giving people who have wronged you so I can teach them what not to do. Because no matter what, I just want happiness for everyone. I don't wish a bad life on anyone. I don't want anyone to hurt because of me. I just want to be the better person. Is that so bad? If my loved ones know what I did, they'd think me crazy. Do you think me crazy? I hope not. I just want to do right by you. I believe the good is in people. Sometimes things like heartbreak have to happen to get to the good. And isn't that what being a Christian is supposed to be about? It doesn't mean you have to forgive or love the person. It just means you want them to realize mistakes so they can have a good life. Am I just stupid? All I know is Christmas. The thought of hurting anyone during Christmas hurts me. I can't help it, but that doesn't mean I'm going back to that life. There is that moment when someone's trust is permanently broken, and I've been through that. Now I'm rebuilding my life from the rubble it made. I love you. I live to honor you. You are number one in my life. Always. In Jesus' name, amen. Good gosh. Yeah, this was around the time where I was trying to be a friend. to my ex, but I was trying to tell him, I was like, I don't love you anymore, I don't want to be with you anymore, I still want a divorce. And he was just like, he kept pushing it, because that's what narcissists and manipulative people do. He kept pushing it, and he was like, I love you, I'll always love you, I'll never stop fighting for you. And like, it was like, he wasn't getting it. So I was like, yeah, this was a mistake trying to be your friend. And that's happened a few times over the months, I'm not gonna lie. I think the last time I talked to him was June 1st. Yeah, that's happened a few times. Actually, June 1st was not my fault. I'd gotten something in the mail that said my debts were paid at the hospital at the beach. And I thought his mom had paid it. So I called their house trying to get in touch with her. But it was like he was right beside the phone. And he started texting me and stuff. And I was like, oh, no, I was trying to get in touch with your mom. And I was like, yep, this was a big mistake. So, yeah, that's never going to happen again. And what's funny is me writing about hurting people during Christmas, but my divorce is probably going to be around Christmas time, so, like, at this point, I don't even care. And it honestly feels so good. So good. Actually, my cousin told me recently that because I don't have kids, that I can get a divorce now, like, right now. So, as soon as I get a job and get some money saved up for a lawyer, it's happening soon. So be praying about that, because I'm ready to be rid of that life. I'm ready to be rid of him. I'm ready to be rid of my in-laws, his friends, like, screw them all, okay? Like, I'm just ready to be rid of that life. And these journal entries just proved to me how weak I was in the beginning. Okay, let's do one more for Christmas. Day 16, life is all about love. Dear God, happy day of your birth. Millions and millions of years ago, what we know about love and sacrifice was born. I've always considered myself to be a selfish person. I want to be loved. I want to be happy. I want to figure my life out. Even now, I is probably one of the top words in my vocabulary. That's why I miss work so much, because at least I was going out every night and sacrificing myself and my heart for others. But even then, I was selfish. I love being awarded for the love I provide people. I didn't want to do things out of the goodness of my own heart. I had to be recognized. I would do things to the fullness of my capability, but I did it all for the wrong reasons. I want my mindset to change. My life is not about me. It's about the love I spread to others, because that is what you did all those years ago. That's why I'm ready to release my hold on my life and just see where my faith takes me. And as scary as that might seem, it has to be done. What am I living for if I'm not living for you? I'm tired of questioning and wondering. The best thing about me is I do have a good heart and I do care for people. I hate the thought of anyone hurting or alone. I'm lucky that I have an amazing support system. Some people in this world are not so lucky. Some people don't even know what real love is. They've never experienced unconditional love because they don't succumb to it. So many people are afraid. Some people don't have faith. I have faith. I do. It's a lot bigger than a mustard seed now. Today it's windy and I can hear my brother's chimes. I don't consider that to be a coincidence. Thank you, God, for being patient with me. I'm trying to change my mindset. I know it takes time, but I know I'm going in the right direction. In Jesus' name, amen. was written on June 19th. Dear God, I hope you don't mind that I've decided to write to you more than profess it with my mouth. I feel like when I write, a part of my heart is seen more when I use my hands over my mouth. Sometimes I do feel like a duckling. I feel like I'm just starting out on this road we call life. I still have no idea where I'm going or who I should be. I feel like every day you are forming new parts of myself using the scars of my past life. Using my scars like it's a roadmap to my purpose in this life. I know there are parts of the past that I'm still hanging on to selfishly, especially when it's things that don't bring you glory. It's like having my heart on my sleeve and watching it break endlessly, like I'm holding out for something that could have been. I know I'm letting the wrong people hurt me. I know it's wrong, and yet I let control my every thought. I've been this way my entire life. Love can be my grace, but it can also be my downfall, because I'm loving the wrong people and spending my energy loving them when that time should be spent loving you. You are my true best friend. You have loved me unconditionally and have been there to catch me when I've fallen. Now I know how you felt all those years when you watched me destroy myself, all the while doing so with you on the back burner. I don't want to be like that anymore. I just want a relationship with you. But I'm human, and sometimes I crave that human love. But I want to focus more on you. You led me to that study Bible today. You blessed me today. I know every day isn't going to be as blessed as today. Sometimes I need to open my eyes more. Sometimes I need to pray and watch you work. I don't want to worry anymore. I want to let you protect your children without me worrying about what I can't control. I need to relinquish control. I know that's the only way I can get through this life with a smile on my face and a grateful heart, knowing that every good thing that happens in my life is because of you. Prayer request. Anyone affected by the tropical storm? Yeah, the one that was supposed to hit Texas. Sorry, my nose started itching. I didn't want to scratch it on camera. Dude, December through recently, I have grieved over a certain friendship that is just sad. You know, I think, was it Eleanor Roosevelt or Dolly Parton or somebody that says, when people show you who they are, believe them. And that just makes me so sad that from December to just recently that I grieved over this friendship. Because why would I grieve over something like that? Like, why, when I have friends that love me, that have shown that they love me, that have been here for me through everything. And it's like, girl, what the hell's wrong with you, you know? But it's okay. Today was one of the first days that I woke up and was happy. And even listening to happy music and going to see that movie with my best friend and her children, I drove home happy. Like, things are changing, you guys. And I can feel it, and it feels really, really good. But there is a part, I'm going to end this video. By the way, I hope you all have a lovely July 4th. I'm probably not going to make another video until this weekend. But remember to put down in the comments what you would want my next top 10 to be for this weekend. And I hope you guys have a wonderful July 4th. And remember, it's Journey's birthday. So don't forget to put happy birthday Journey in the comments. I'll probably put a picture up of him on his birthday, I'm not gonna lie. But spoilers. I don't want to ruin the movie for you guys, but I am just going to make a pros and cons list about myself. Like words, just simple words to describe myself to end this video. So, I am loved. I am impatient. I am beautiful. I am self-conscious. I have great friends. I love the wrong people. I wear my heart on my sleeve. I have a kind heart. I'm caring. I'm selfish. I can be angry. I love God, but I'm not a perfect Christian. I'm a sinner. But I love with my entire heart. I think I'm a good ASMR artist. And I love you guys, but that's off the top of my head. That's all I can think about right now. But, okay, since I've been seeing the number 33, so many times today that I want to end this video on 33. So let's think of a few more.